Hey guys, it's Queendija, and in today's video, I'll be reacting to episode 12 of Demon Slayer. So let's go ahead and get started in 3, 2, 1, go. Now you tell her that. Even though I think he said it in episode 11. It's hot. Yeah, I got like fucking 10 times hotter in here. Even though I have the air on. What? Fuck it. No. Well, damn, you ain't got a step on her! Get off her! Who the hell are you? Okay. Are you serious? Yeah, because he's getting annoyed by you two. Probably none of this would have fucking happened if the brother and sister would have just stayed their ass outside with Nezuko. Right. Was that her brother? Or no? Nothing. Oh. Just thank God I wasn't her brother. Okay, here's one thing I gotta fucking say. You telling me, dude who is blind, that's Dobby's voice acting. No way in hell, I still can't believe it. You telling me, his scared voice also plays that high. That's Nah, dude, you're being a puss. That or Kimetsu might find you. Oh shit. I mean, he technically ran into you. It wasn't. Are you? Okay. He's coming. You know, we're not gonna make this like a horror movie where you fucking die. So get the fuck up. He'll die. Are you fucking serious? Who the fuck falls asleep during a time like that? Maybe if he, when he falls asleep, he goes into, like, this ultimate badass power. I don't know. And then he's not gonna remember that he did all this. Mm-hmm. Holy shit! Oh my god! Oh my god! Fucking finally! And you don't remember any of that, do you? Now it's quite the other way around, then. Dude, you've been here for 3 damn days? Kirito, what the fuck? How many fucking demons are in this damn place? Damn. It's too fucking easy. Damn. Unfortunately, you don't have any more time. Damn, he just fucking throws him away like goddamn trash. Don't come closer. Why do I feel like he's just there as a trap for them? Okay, let's get you out of here. more. So basically, they're now walking around the area. Okay. He's not going to do anything. Someone's close. But see, you say that. What's up, bub? And the one on the left is the left. Of course. Yeah, and plus Nezuko isn't here, so you're, I'm not gonna say you're screwed, but you're screwed! Thank You gotta sit now, okay? Ooh! So, okay, basically it's going to look like it's just going to be him going against him by himself. Even though I'm okay with that, but I kind of want either Zenitsu, even though he's only OP when he falls asleep, and then, you know, boar-looking guy, boarhead dude, aka Hirito, to come, but if he comes, he's just going to immediately attack Tanjiro for no fucking reason. Because he stepped on that damn girl. Don't do that shit. But Zenitsu, I have to applaud that boy because I was expecting this mother effer not to do shit in this episode, just to cry the whole damn time. But no, he actually held his own. But the thing is, it's like he doesn't remember when he's just normal. He's back to a crying crybaby. And I don't know. I like him. Still really funny that it's Dobby's voice actor, but because there's no way in hell that I would have thought that until somebody fucking tweeted something, and I was like, are you fucking serious? You just gotta fucking love him. It's just sad that he doesn't remember anything. But I have to say, like, both fights were good. Like, the start of one fight going into the other. I mean, but seriously, as I said, if Nezuko was there, I think it would have just been done in, like, under 10 seconds. Maybe even under 5. But because of the fact that she's not there to at least help him, he is on his own until at least maybe Zenitsu or Kirito, quote-unquote, at least comes. But then if, you know, boarhead Kirito does come, who knows if he's going to help him? And then, like I said, with Zenitsu, you know, he's not really useless. But when he falls asleep... No, you know what, no. He's like freaking Megumin. That's what he's like. He goes to sleep, and then he can only use his power once and one time only, and then after that, he is useless. Not that I'm saying that Megumin is useless. I think I did say it when I did a reaction on Konosuba, but I still love her. It's just the same time, I'm like, damn, like, that's all you can fucking do, but I'm like, that's what I love her for, but, I feel like Zenitsu could do more, but I think it's maybe the longer he sleeps, the more power he absorbs, and the more OP he is. Because as of right now, like, Tanjiro is the most OP character in this show. And Zenitsu, I would say he's... I mean, we've barely seen Boarhead Guy, like, fight. So I would still put him in second until we get to see more of him in action. And that's why I kind of want him to join Tanjiro in this next battle, but we technically had him in it, and he was gone for, like, a second after that. But yeah, Zenitsu's more, like, third level OP, and he just needs to get to that number one or that number two spot, but I don't think he's gonna get there. I think for him, he has a long way to go, and then maybe, just maybe, by the time this series is over, he could be really OP as hell, but right now, no, he's just, he's semi-OP and a crying baby, and that's okay, I love him, he's got a long way to go. I feel like, he's gonna need a lot of training, let's just say that. But the fact is, I hate when he woke back up. He's that dude, did it? Be like, oh my god, why didn't you tell me you had this power? I'd be like, oh my god, if you only knew that it was you. But you don't remember which fucking sucks. Which really, because he reminds me a lot of fucking Hayato from 100, because when Hayato is in his quote unquote rage form, he's badass as fuck, but then once he's, like, out of it, he really doesn't remember anything that he's done. And see, because we're in the world of not any damn video cameras, cell phones, and ish, we can't record what he did. But, I mean, it's better if, like, the kid who's with him just describes everything. Thank God the brother's not dead yet. But, I mean, because he is someone who has a very rare type of blood. He's kind of like, even though I haven't watched the show in a while, he's like Ruby from Ruby. So he's majorly important, and you have to protect him. But he'll be okay. Tanjiro just has to kill Archer. That's all. But I mean, he looks too OP. I don't know how this is gonna go until next week. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction to towards episode 12 of Demon Slayer. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Magical Squad. And of course, I will see you guys officially all next Saturday for episode 13. Bye, guys.